Police investigate an officer-involved shooting that ended with a suspect dead. KMBC 9's David Hall joining us live from the scene. David?
Yes, this officer-involved shooting happened here in the Power and Light District, a pretty popular area, especially in the evening times on the weekends. And it started with a chase and ended in deadly gunfire.
Police say they got called out to 13th and Grand because 24-year-old Ryan Stokes was stealing. Officers tell us there was a foot chase, and when they got close to Stokes, he pointed a gun at them, refusing to drop it. That's when police say they shot him and killed him. Greg McCarron knows this area well and says the officers had a tough call to make.
Well, it's a shame. It was a busy area. There's a lot of people around, especially at 2 o'clock in the morning. I imagine there's still a lot of people around, a lot of intoxicated people. And, you know, things like this are going to happen if the officer felt like his life was in danger, I guess, or other people's lives might be in danger, especially if the guy had a gun. You know, he did what he had to do, and I mean, it's a shame, but things like this will happen.
I feel bad that the gentleman was actually shot and killed.
Sunday afternoon, we ran into Justin Karleski. You know, he was one of several people who packed the Power and Light District to watch a soccer game on the big screen TV. He heard that just hours earlier, near here, was the scene of a deadly shooting.
Somebody commits a crime, they should be punished, maybe not in the way of a death.
As for their own safety, these two men have expectations for the police.
They do have to protect people, and it sounds like in this case they did what they had to do.
Oh, I expect them to, you know, keep us all safe. We're out here just trying to have a good time.
And I called the police department and Power and Light representatives for comments, but they did not get back in touch with me. Reporting live, I'm David Hall, KMBC 9 News.
As is usually the case, the officers involved have been placed on administrative leave pending an investigation.